celebrate the solemn feast of Christ the King, let us ask the Lord to forgive our sins. Lord Jesus, you seek out the lost and bring them back. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you heal the sick and feed the hungry. Christ, have mercy. Jesus, you are the Savior of the world. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came for man, the resurrection of the dead came also for man. For just as in Adam all died, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ, the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ, then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. When everything is subjected to him, then the Son himself will also be subjected to the one who subjected everything to him, so that God may be all in all. The word of the Lord.
Basis, we really make a mental contribution
always indicated to us what real class was all about, what it meant to be a king, to be the Prince of Peace. Just everything he said, the way he spoke, the way he behaved, what he accepted, and the fact that he was non-judgmental, and the fact that he was continually loving and never running out of patience, and always finding a solution. All the things that you would expect a king to be able to do for his people. And in history, we've had some dreadful kings. We've also had some wonderful people who, in their own way, imitated Christ by their goodness and their concern for the people that they ruled over. When we come to a feast like this, we get a little bit of a taste. You know, as Americans, we don't understand loyalty. It's not part of our tradition, but on this holiday, there's something about it that makes us stand a little taller, like certain hope, so that when the Lord looks upon us, he might see a royal people, which is what we should be, because we're the subjects of the king. It's easier than you think to be royal, I believe. I go every year into New York to New York Presbyterian Diocese, and because the doctor normally dilates your eyes, I always get a writer. I'm from Franklin, Georgia, who, among many wonderful talents he has, is also an Uber driver. So he takes me into the city and into the doctor's office, and I get my eyes examined, and he drives me home. We went this Thursday, and I text him when I'm through with the exam, because he parks a couple of blocks away from his little bunch of movie. And I texted him to come to get me in front of his own car. He texted me back and he said, "Father, I can't get the car started. It's all started." So I walked over to where he was a couple of blocks, and he was on his cell phone. He was talking to somebody about, I guess, the manufacturer of the car to find out what all the lights on the dashboard were telling him about the car. And they must have said, "That's a new battery." So he was trying to find somebody that would come to give us the charge for the car, charge. And as we're there, I don't remember, but I think probably with the hood up, because anybody who knows nothing about cars, when they break down, open the hood, because they think the air is going to fix it. So of course we're going to waiting for the air to fix the car. And we're in the middle of the street that we parked, and this vehicle that was sort of the kind that you bring handicapped people to places and the sticker on it, drives by, and he sees that we're in some consciousness mode, and he gets, pulls the car over, and he comes back, and he looks, and he spoke to Giorgio in Spanish, and I guess he must have said there was something wrong with the battery of the car, and the man went back into his truck, came out, and I watched him do this, and he didn't come out with anything, he just went in and came out. And he looked into the front of the car, and he pulled his cell phone out of his pocket, and he jump-started the car with his cell phone. And our mouths just dropped open. I mean, you know you can do all kinds of stuff with that, but that was unbelievable. So, of course, we were elated, and thank you, and put the hood down and all that kind of stuff. And he went back into his little truck, and Giorgio and I, running around with our hands in our pockets to try to get some money to tip the guy, because he really helped us out of a jam. He said, "Oh no, it's on me. God bless you." Let's do the math. We were broken down. We were in trouble. He didn't have to stop. He stops, he fixed the car, and then he won't take a tip and blesses us. That's royal. Can you imagine an entire world of people who did that? People who were not so much obsessed with all of their rights as much as they were obsessed with all of their opportunities, their chances to be able to do wonderful things for their brothers and sisters. We're in the heart of New York City, where some people think that good people are many times. And here, this man who doesn't know us does something to my mind, the thought is a royal gesture. I think this gospel is about those who get it and those who don't. let's hope that we as believing people in our particular situation as Roman Catholics can behave that regally so that maybe some of the people who don't yet get it may look at us and say, you know what, there's something royal about those people. I would like to be a part of the way they live. If we do that, then we're behaving as the royal and holy people that Christ has called us to be. We build up his kingdom on this earth. And if we do that, we truly please the Lord and in the process save our souls. Let us continue with our liturgy. I invite all of you to stand together and give us a prayer. I believe God, Father, Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, and died on the cross. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, in the Church, in the union of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, let us call to mind the needs of the church and the world, bringing our concerns constantly before God's throne, and our response to the petitions are the words, King of Kings, hear our prayer.
That the church proclaim the good news of God's reign, let us pray to the Lord.
King of Kings, hear our prayer.
That the hungry be fed, the homeless find haven, the lonely be comforted, and those in prison know true freedom, let us pray to the Lord.
King of Kings, hear our prayer.
That during this week of Thanksgiving, we may be grateful for all good gifts God has given. Let us pray to the Lord.
King of Kings, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and those who are close to death, and those who care for them, that they know the reality of God's love, let us pray to the Lord.
King of Kings, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Margaret Butler Cuccinello, whom this Mass is offered, and William Garcia and John Marshall died recently, that they may now share in the heavenly banquet with Christ our King. Let us pray to the Lord.
Kings, hear our prayer. Almighty and holy God, until the day you call us into your reign, grant we ask of your power of the Holy Spirit in the name of your Son, Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
offering himself on the altar of the cross, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption. And making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with all the angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions and the Lord, the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy,
holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna. The time of betrayal and unwillingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more gave thanks and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this." The mystery of faith, when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you call us worthy of being in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that we are taking the sacrament of Christ and gathering into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring us to the fullest of charity together with Kevin, our bishop, Francis, the bishop of Rome, our pastor, Father Stephen, the religious sisters and brothers, all the people of faith. Remember also those who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the martyrs, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, we pray for every evil, graciously grant peace in our days. And give to all people their daily bread, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and glory of our Lord is now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, if not our sin, but upon our faith, grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom when you live forever and ever. Peace to the Lord be always. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but on the same word my soul shall be healed, and the body of Christ will bring us. us all to everlasting life. Many different levels in your lives, and not ourselves. We really need to turn our eyes and our thoughts and our prayers and our hearts to God and be very grateful for whatever it is that we have. Because in my humble belief, and I'm sure that all of you agree with me, what we have comes from His bounty and His grace directly or through our brothers and sisters. So it is a time of thanksgiving, and I hope for all of you, you're able to take a moment to really address the Lord and your brothers and sisters, and thank those who have provided you life and gratitude. So enjoy and have a safe and happy and healthy day. Let us pray. According to Jesus Christ, the King of all creation, has fully for everlasting life. Help us to live by His gospel and bring us to the joy of His kingdom where He lives and reigns forever and ever. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Love and serve the Lord and one another. Thanks be to God.